Hi, I'm Lauren Paradise, the librarian for Dash, and in this video, I'll be giving you the steps to do one of the research data tasks I most commonly get asked about, how to get census data onto your map in ArcGIS. The Census website has a page where you can download a zip file or geodatabase with shapefiles for counties, census tracts, or other geographic divisions, along with the census or American Community Survey data and projections for that area. You can get to this site from the GIS section of the library's Dash Guide at lib.manhattan.edu/dash/GIS and scroll to the link that says Tiger Line Demographic Maps. When you start off at this site, you first want to figure out what geographic division will help you the most. That depends on what you want to be comparing the census data to. If you're just looking at an individual borough in New York City and you have point level data, like where 311 calls are, you'll probably want census tract level data. We are going to get more into this example later. If you're comparing county level initiatives within the same state, you'd want county level data. If you want to compare election results to census data, you'd want to pick the congressional district if you were looking at federal data, or state legislative data if you were interested in state level results. For these categories, the ones that don't let you pick the state first, you are downloading data for that geographic division for the whole country. That's why the files are so big. So you'll need to have a shapefile for your state or the smaller area in that state that you're most interested in, so you can clip the shapefile that covers the whole country into just the part of it that covers your state or other area of interest. We'll get into how to clip later in this video. Within this video, I'll be showing you how to get the census tract shapefile with its corresponding data for all of New York State, clip it to just New York City, join the shapefile to the data, and then symbolize an aspect of that data for the census tracts of the map. When you know how to do this, you'll be able to apply that knowledge to other levels of census data and other locations. To get the census tract level data, go to the bottom of the page, and in the Select State drop-down under Census Tract, choose New York. It may take a bit to download. When it is done, move the downloaded zip file to whatever folder you've been accessing your files in for ArcGIS Pro. Extract the zip file. This might take a bit. Open a new project in ArcGIS Pro. Then add a connection to the folder that you've been storing your map-related files in. When you view the contents of the Census Geo database in ArcGIS Pro, you'll see that it has two different kinds of data, the shapefile of all the census tracts, and tables that have a number and a short descriptive title. These are the tables that you will look at Tiger Line's documentation in order to see which one has the data you want to put on your map. More on that later in the video. Copy and paste the shapefile from this geodatabase into the home geodatabase for your project. This will be a very important step if you want to access the map you made from another computer. Drag the shapefile from your home geodatabase onto your map, and it will show up on your screen as the outline of New York State, but cut up into chunks of varying size. Now, if you try and join and map data for this whole state, it's going to take forever. And whenever you move around on the map, ArcGIS will spend time calculating and maybe even crash. In this case, we're only interested in New York City, so I'm going to clip this file to just show the tracts in New York City. Also, in my folder of map downloads, I have a borough map of New York City, which I will copy and paste into the home folder for my project. I got this borough map from New York City's Bites of the Big Apple site, which is also linked to on the GIS section of the Dash Research Guide. From my home folder, I'll drag the borough map on top of the census map. Then I'll zoom to this layer, and you'll see that it lines up with the part of the larger census map that's over New York City. Next, I'll choose Analysis, and then from Tools, Pairwise Clip. For input features, I'll choose the census tract layer, since that's what I'd like to be clipped. For clip features, I'll choose the burrow layer since that's what I want it to use as a guide for what to clip from the census tract map. For output features, I'll change the name of the census tract file to say just NYC. When that finishes, turn off the other layers, and you should just have a map of the census tract cropped to the borders of NYC's boroughs. Next, you'll want to be joining this map to whichever table has the information that you want to visualize. To know which table this is, you need to go back to the Tiger Line website and look up the technical documentation for the ACS shapefile that you chose. Just note that this information is also downloaded in the zip file, just in case you're in a situation where you have to work on this without internet access. I'll be showing you on the website, since it's easier for me to search in the web browser. On this page, find the link to the metadata for the geographic level that you used. We use census tract, so I'll choose that link. Metadata means information that describes the data that you're using. When you open any of the tables with the community data, you'll see that after the first few columns, all of the columns in this table have titles that are these strings of letters and numbers. That's because the amount of detail in each census measure contains so many words that they couldn't make each column title be as long as, for example, a string like this. So, they give it a unique ID because otherwise the table in the zip file would get too large and unwieldy. You use this sheet to find what unique ID goes with the measure that you want to use on your map. First off, I'll be looking for the measure that I want to map for New York City, median household income. I'll do a search for that term in the technical documentation and look at the descriptions for what comes up until I find the figure that I need. I'll want to make sure that the entry that I pick says estimate instead of margin for error, and that it doesn't have any extra variables that I don't care about for my data. If you look down on the sheet, you'll see that some of the median household numbers are classified by race, and if you scroll up, you'll see that there are also measures that show how many homes, not a percentage of them, have what household income. Those may be measures that you'd care about for another project, but for mine, I only wanted the measure of what the median income was for that census tract. Next to the measure that I've chosen, there will be a number that starts with B. That's the column that has this information on a table. It says it's B19013E1. That means it's on the sheet labeled 19 and that the column labeled B19013E1 has the data for the median household income estimate. Within the geo database that I downloaded, there's a sheet titled X19 Income. I'll copy the file and paste it into my home geo database for this project. Then I'll drag the table from that geo database onto the contents pane. Right-click on the income table and choose Open. Next, I'll scroll over into this sheet until I find B19013E1. I'm going to rename this column so I know what it is when I look for this measure to graph it. Right-click on this column and choose Fields. In this window, scroll until you find this column that you've highlighted and click to change the alias. Copy and paste the name of this measure from the census tract metadata. Then in the Fields menu up top, click Save. Now that you've altered the income table so that you'll be able to see which column you want to display on your map, it's time to join this table to the layer you created of the census tracts in New York City so you can symbolize the differing household incomes in those tracts. To do that, first make sure you know which is the field that contains the census tract's ID in both the income table and the New York City Maps attribute table. They came from the same source, so it's pretty straightforward. In the income table, scroll to the beginning of the table and see that the first column is GEOID and the first number is a long string starting with 14,000 US. Now for the census tract map for New York City, open the attribute table. You're looking for a column that has numbers that look like the GOID in the income document. That appears to be GOID data, since the numbers have the same kind of formatting, 14,000 US followed by a long string of numbers. Go to the Census Tract Map layer, right-click and choose Joins and Relates, Add Join. You'll choose that the field in the layer that you want the join based on is GOID data, that you want to join the layer to the income table. Select that the field you want the join based on the income table is GOID. It may take a bit to index these tables. Select the button for Validate Join. It will go through both tables and make sure that a join will work. If you've done everything right, you'll see that it's matched all of the entries together. If this validate join step went OK, close the box and then on the original pop-up, choose OK. To look at the map, you'd think nothing had changed. But when you open the attribute table, you can see the join worked. Scroll through, you'll see that there are now a lot of columns that have that B19 naming structure from the income chart. That means you can use these columns to symbolize the data in them for that census tract. Right-click on the NYC census tract map and choose Symbology. Currently, it's set to single symbol. Switch it to graduated colors, so census tracts will be different colors based on their median household income. To make the colors determined by median household income, select that column in the field drop-down, and the map will change. I'll do more customization, changing the number of classes to 7, the color scheme to be blue, and the labels to be formatted as currency. You'll see the map now has varying colors of blue for each census tract based on the median household income for that tract. This lets you see that each borough has different distribution patterns. This is a thing that can help if you have data that you want to compare to some kind of demographic measure. For instance, when I drag the subway stops layer on top of the map, I can see if tracts that do not contain a subway stop have a higher or lower median income than tracts that have one or several. With this package, there are lots of different census numbers you can graph to the census tracts on the map. This can help you ask all kinds of demographic questions about whatever other layers of data you have on your map. For more ArcGIS tutorials, please see the GIS guide on the Dash Research Guide at lib.manhattan.edu/dash/GIS.